Yo, what's going on, guys? So today we have a video on this Mercedes 190E. It's my boy Jorgy. He trusted me to give it a nice a paint restoration. Pretty much we went ahead and did the body work, repainted it. It was a two-tone, but he eliminated that. He wanted to go with one solid color. We were doing some wet sanding on the wing just to get something smoothed out. That's why it looks pretty rough right now. He added this top trim piece, which I think looks really nice. He added the little skirts, and these are called, what are these called? Fender flares. Sorry, I lost my train of thought right there real quick. We also went ahead and replaced the gums on these mirrors because the other ones were just really, really corroded. We went in and touched up with some flat black on the door handles. He did add some aftermarket side skirts, as well as a front bumper. It is an aftermarket fiberglass bumper. We went ahead and gave it a nice two-tone with the flat black and then the color match. He upgraded the headlights, put a new grille on it. There are a few details that are missing. For example, this trim piece, it's not missing, it's in there, but I did notice some imperfections on the paint, so I'm gonna go ahead and reshoot it. We also changed up all the seals all around, so these are brand new seals. The only thing is that they are pretty thick, so you do kind of have to slam the door a little to get it to shut nice and smooth. We also added this wing. Actually, I kind of overlooked that, but this wing wasn't part of the car. We went ahead and drilled the holes and added it to it. But it is leaking some water, so we are gonna throw some seam sealer, or maybe we'll see exactly what we can put through the inside, because look, I could probably might show y'all right here. Okay, thankfully there's no water that's dripping, but it has holes right here. Oh, you might not be able to see it too well, but anyways, they're not fully sealed, so the water seeps through. The wing did have like some little styrofoam gaskets, but it doesn't seem that they are really doing the job. So we're gonna just go ahead, and I need to clean up this primer. I'm just now noticing it. But yeah, we are gonna go ahead and seam seal that real quick, patch that up. And there is another little trim piece back here. Okay, I can't find it right now, so I probably moved it to the front, but it's a little trim piece that goes here. That one there is gonna go matte black to match this little trim piece right here on the rear bumper, which again, the rear bumper is an aftermarket bumper as well. It's a fiberglass, and you went ahead and made that look real, real nice. But what I'm gonna do right now is focus on re-wet sanding this panel here, and then the windshield wiper arm. This piece, it is gonna get color matched, so I do have to remove it. I have to remove a couple things on this side to get this to come off. And then there are some trims that go under the headlights, which we have over here, which are these right here. So these will have to get color matched as well. And then these are the OEM bolts that'll hold on to it. But that's not where we're stopping. If we go back here, this is the trim piece I'm saying I'm gonna repaint. And then this one here went on the back panel, but the bumper goes over it, so we didn't need to use that one. So it's just sitting back here. It's spare if he ever goes back to the OEM bumper. But here they are. This car does have headlight windshield wipers. I think that's pretty dope. So we will have to install these as well onto those trim pieces, which I think I'm gonna install them first and then paint, just to make sure I don't damage the paint. And I have both of them sitting here. And I found that rear trim piece back here as well that goes on the trunk lid. So there's that. And then there's a couple miscellaneous extra pieces here. For example, I'm not sure where these wipers are from, and a couple extra badges because he replaced them. The interior is gonna get a full swap. So that's where it's going after we finish our part of the job. But yeah, guys, I'm pretty excited. Like I said, right now I'm gonna be working on just removing this wiper, and then I'm gonna get everything sanded. I probably won't film any of this, and then I'll go ahead and shoot it, but I'll probably just show y'all once I have everything painted. Might show a little bit of the prep work. We'll see depending on what I'm able to get footage of. But guys, we're gonna go ahead and get to it. All right guys, so I got the windshield wiper off. It is mechanical because it is an older car. So as you can see, it has all these mechanical mechanisms. And a lot did have to come off. I had to take off that trim piece, the little, the other trims that it had. Had more trims right there on the window. And then the motor actually came out as well. Then it cleared out this whole area right here. It was not as difficult, thankfully. It was pretty bolt on, but it was a little difficult to try to get into this area. See, I even dropped my ratchet. It was a little difficult to get into that area, but I managed. It wasn't nothing too terrible. So now we're just gonna prep this for paint and then prep up the trims and we'll be good to go. So I just got off the phone with Jorgy and it was clutch that he called, because he just told me he does not want the wipers for the headlights installed anymore. And I sent him a picture of how, when I removed it, just because I thought it was crazy how I had to remove almost the whole outer dash. And then he went ahead and told me, like, hey bro, I have a new windshield wiper motor in the trunk. Can you go ahead and swap that out for me? And I mean, it's right here. It's really accessible. I literally just have to release these clips, plug them onto this one, and we're golden. So I'm gonna go ahead and take care of that off camera real quick. And then once that's done, I'm gonna go back into the bay and continue to prep the trims for the headlights and the windshield wiper. So let's get to it. Guys, it's crazy. It literally took me 30 seconds. All I had to do was undo the clip, clip this one on, took it in here, and it's golden. It's good to go. So now that that's done, let's go and tackle the wiper. All right, guys. So I have my pieces in the booth. These are the headlight trim pieces, the windshield wiper, and then the side panel trim. And then let me show y'all what I was talking about. If we look right over here, let me adjust the camera. Look, you can see it wasn't feathered out from the previous paint, and it was just kind of painted over and it left that texture. And that's a big no-no. So it's a slip up, it happens, but you know what, we're gonna go ahead and take care of it. It's not gonna stay like that, and it is on the driver's side, so it's gonna be extra noticeable. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and wet sand this with 600, hit these with 600, feather them out. Might apply some putty because there are a couple rock chips here and there. And then we're just gonna sand. I believe it was mainly this piece that he wanted painted. I might just go ahead and do up into here. Just this whole piece, the actual arm, I believe he did not want color matched. I will double check with him though. And then I'll start sanding. So once I have these sprayed and shot up, I'll go ahead and show you how that looks. All right guys, so I went ahead and put some tape under these and kind of taped off the edge a little, not much. It's not gonna be visible, so it won't affect it, but that's just so they don't blow away since they are very light, but they are wet sanded. Same with this panel here. It is nice and wet sanded. And then the windshield wiper, I went ahead and masked off all the mechanical mechanisms and then wet sand it. I hit up Jorgy, and he actually did want the whole arm. There was this bracket that I was missing, but I'm glad I found it. It was in the engine bay area. So I went ahead and snapped it on and sanded everything. So we are gonna paint the whole arm, that whole panel, and then these two trims. And again, we won't be doing the wipers. So everything is nice and wet sanded. I'm gonna go ahead and wax and grease remove it and start shooting. And then I'll show y'all once it's done. Once I've hit it with my two coats of base and my three coats of clear. So let's get it. Yo, check it out, guys. Ooh, man, mirror finish looking crisp. So this is obviously the windshield wiper here. We got the trim piece as well. And if you look, where it had the damages, they're no longer there. So that's really good. And then the trim pieces that go under the headlights look real nice, shiny. Really love the outcome. I went ahead and hit it with four coats of clear because I ended up mixing a little too much, but hey, a lot of clear, more clears, it's always better. So we're not complaining. And I did have them under the heat lamp, so touching this other clear, the overspray, it does seem fairly dry, still a little gummy though. So I'm gonna let these sit overnight. I'm not gonna try to install them or mess with them just yet. And then tomorrow we're gonna reinstall these pieces, give the car a nice wash, because it really, really deserves it. And there's a couple spots that I still have to polish, so I'm gonna go ahead and take care of that. And then the car should be pretty much ready for pickup. Check it out, guys. Car's still dusty, so a wash is next. But check it out, the wipers installed, nice and color matched. And man, boy, does this thing make a difference. The nice gloss, the smoothness, and the fact that it just matches the car looks really, really nice. And then we got the headlight trims installed as well. As you can see, the gaps are now covered up, so it looks a lot nicer on the front. I really, really like how it looks now. And we got the door panel on as well. Nice and fixed up. This is where the imperfections were at previously. But again, we went ahead and feathered that out. So now, if we take a look on the side angle, sheesh, golden. But we're not finished there yet, guys. Like I said, we're still gonna give this car a nice wash. It has been sitting for a while, so I will have to jump it. I'm gonna go ahead and move my truck out of the way, place the car a little bit more towards the center. All right, guys, so before I actually started washing the car, I remembered that I did have to patch up the holes that were on the inside. And as you can see, it looks a little messy, but I threw the seam sealer in there and on this one. So I patched up the holes. I went ahead with some black spray paint just so it doesn't stand out as much. And you know, so it doesn't look as ugly. So yeah, I'm letting the trunk open so the sun can bake that up and dry up that paint. Once that's nice and dry, I will go ahead and shut it and then proceed with washing the car. Check it out, guys. Finally give it a nice wash. And man, look at that paint. Stunning. It's looking real nice and shiny. Just how we wanted it to. It did have a bunch of dust from just kind of sitting in our lot. We were waiting on those headlight trims, because unfortunately I misplaced them, but thankfully Jorgy, he ended up buying a new car to swap the interior, so we got the donors out of those. There are still a couple spots we need to finish buffing, like that spot there. The wing did have a couple, you know, right here, still has to get buffed out. And I believe there's another spot here, but that's very minimal work. The rear trim, it's already painted flat black. We just have to install it. I did test out the trunk to see how well it's sealed, and this side is still leaking a little bit because we did run the wire, and the wire's kind of in the way of applying the seam sealer fully all the way. So I might have to do some additional cuts just to get more access through the inside of the trunk, just to get some access. Oh look, you saw it right there. So I might have to just make this hole bigger around here and get better access, just so I can seam seal it nicely and it can stop leaking. And then the wire, we are gonna rerun it so that it runs with this one and it's hitting and it's not just dangling there. So just a couple minor touches, nothing major. But other than that, check it out, guys. Let me get y'all a wide angle, give y'all a quick other walk around. Man, this thing looks real nice. And he will be dailying this car, so I know for a fact he's gonna catch a lot of attention. Man, just look at it. A bigger wing would have been nicer, I'll be honest with you. I know these normally have that exaggerated wing. It looks really, really nice. But I like this one too, it's nice and subtle. Kind of reminds me of that Grand Theft Auto 3 car, the one from the mobsters. So that's pretty cool. Reminisce on the childhood right there. But yeah, guys, just a couple final touches and the car is good to go and good as new.